Good day, folks, and welcome back to our YouTube channel, Gary, Betty Leet, the Old Church, 5 Acre Homestead. Well, I'm down here now at the Old Church, and I'm getting ready to do a little electrical job. I'm installing a reciprocal outlet today, and I will begin by saying this disclaimer. If you are not comfortable doing electrical work, then by all means, you should get a qualified electrician to do this kind of work for you. Now, I'm a DIY person. I've been doing a lot of my own work for many, many years, and I've put lots of these reciprocals in, plugins and switches and lights and all that good stuff. I've done that for years, and I'm quite confident and capable of doing this kind of work. But I'm going to walk you through this process now of how to install a reciprocal. It's not a difficult task, but again, I will say, for safety reasons, make sure that you have to be comfortable with this kind of work. If you are not, get a qualified electrician to do it. The very first thing you need to do, of course, is make sure that the power to the reciprocal is turned off. And in fact, this reciprocal does not have any power. It's not live. So therefore, I can go ahead and be comfortable working with the wire that's in this box and hook up the reciprocal today. I'm going to walk you through it. I'll try to do it step by step. So if you want to do something like this yourself, you can certainly go ahead. The tools that you will need to install a reciprocal are, you will need a pair of wire cutters, which I have here. You will need also a pair of needle nose pliers, which I have. I have a multi-purpose tool, but you'll need something with a blade with a little bit of a knife to it to do some stripping some of the wire off the ends there, or get yourself a proper wire stripper. I have one, but it's back in Gander in my garage, so I'm using this blade here to do the job for me. You'll also need 3 or 4 different screwdrivers. I have a flat top, which I'll be using to put on the plate at the very end, and I have a couple of Robinson screwdrivers here, square top ones of different sizes that I'm going to need to install the reciprocal in a second. You're going to need some electrical tape, and we'll be using that. You will, of course, need a reciprocal. Here's the electrical reciprocal. It has 2 silver or nickel plated screws on one side, and it has 2 brass color screws on the other side. And I'll talk about that in the video shortly. And of course, you're going to need the plate. Now, with all of that there laid out and ready to go, we do need to do some wire stripping. So I've got a little bit started here. So I'm going to take off the outside insulation. Okay, so that's going to be removed. Another thing you got to make sure too, folks, is that the wires coming into the back of the reciprocal are secured to the back. So you'll need to do that, and you'll need to use your larger Robinson screwdriver just to screw the safety clamp at the back in nice and tight, so the wire is nice and firm there. So I've got that done to the bottom one. This top one, now you might say, well, how come there's 2 wires here? That's because I'm wiring a couple of reciprocals together. So this wire that I'm shaving the outside insulation from now, that wire is going to another reciprocal over here on the end. So that's taken off. Now, I can take care of my ground wires now first, so let me do that. So here's my 2 ground wires. I'm going to secure those to the back of the box using my Robinson screwdriver, and I'm going to make sure that the wires are twisted together. These 2 brass ones that do not have any insulation on them, they're your ground wires, and they need to be secured to the back of the box. Now, there's also a ground screw on your reciprocal. You'll see it right there. Okay, the brass ground wire also needs to be twisted around that screw and that screw tightened up. And we'll do that shortly as well. Okay, so here I go. I'm going to secure the ground wire to the back here. Now, I'm going to use my needle nose pliers also. And I'm going to twist it around the screw that's back there. Okay, it takes a little bit of time. But not a lot. I'll get her done. I'm a fan of Larry the Cable Guy. I don't know if you are, but one of Larry's favorite sayings is, get her done. And I say that quite often too. Let's get her done. Okay, so I got it secured around the screw there now, my ground wire. I'm tightening up the ground screw. Okay, nice and tight. Okay, so that one's done. Now, I'm going to twist it now around the other one. Okay. And I want to save enough of this one to go on the reciprocal box. Okay, that's enough. Okay, so you got to have it good and grounded, folks. I'm going to cut off the end there now. Don't need that. Okay, so like I said, this ground wire now is going to be curled, and it's going to be put on that green ground screw that's on the reciprocal, and it'll be secured onto the reciprocal itself in a second shortly. Okay, now I want to shave off a little bit of insulation from all of these wires. There's two black ones, of course, and two white ones. So I'm just going to take off a little bit there now, folks. If I had my wire strippers, that would make the job a little bit easier, but I'm just using a multi-tool here now that has a blade in it. So I'll do that. Don't take off a lot, about 3/4 to an inch is all you need. Okay, there's one. Do the other one. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to put a curl in these, folks. Just watch how I do this. Now just put a little curl into it, like a U. Okay. I'm going to do the same thing with this black one. Okay, you don't need a lot of the insulation taken off the wire. Just enough. There's an important reason for that. And I'll mention that shortly too. So I got curls put in all my four pieces of wire. Okay, now, the two wires that are coming into the box, okay, bringing the power to the box, I'm going to use those. One will go on the bottom of this brass screw, the black one, and the white one will go on the nickel-colored, the silver-colored one. Okay, so notice how I put it on, and I got my curl there made. I'm going to try to pull it together. Okay, nib it together, which I just did. Now I'm going to need my smaller Robinson to just move the screw in. Some of you might be saying, why aren't you using a drill? I don't use drills for when I'm doing this kind of electrical work because you can't control the torque, really, on a drill when you're doing this kind of work. And you want to be careful that you don't put the screws in too tight. It's just, you get a good feel for it when you're using the screwdrivers. Okay, so I have the black one put on there. I'm going to put the white one over on the other side now. Okay, doing the same kind of a process, folks. Just make sure that the loop goes around. Get your needle nose pliers and close the loop up a little bit. Okay. All right, so that's done. Use the smaller Robinson screwdriver again. Tighten her up. Okay, got that done. All right, so those are on. Going to do the same thing with the top ones. Okay, so the black one goes over here. A rule or a little saying that I have to help me remember where the wires go is I'll use the phrase B&B, black on brass. Okay, so your black wires will go on your brass screws, and that way it'll help you remember what you're doing. Okay, tighten it up again around the screw so it's hidden underneath the screw. Okay, tighten it up there, Gary. And we have one more to go. The other white one will go over here. Same kind of process. Put the loop around the screw. Okay, needle nose. Close up the loop. tighten up the screw. Okay, now you'll notice that you can't see any naked wire on my screw heads. It's all in underneath the screw, and that's very important. Just shave off enough of the insulation so that it's hidden underneath the screw. You don't want any live wire visible from these here, because when you poke the reciprocal back into the box, arcing could happen, which means electricity is going to travel between the naked wire that's sticking out and probably touching this side of the box. And that's quite dangerous. Now, I've got my ground left here now. So I'm gonna twist that around, and I'm gonna twist that onto the green screw. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna put a loop in my ground wire, this brass one. See, I got my loop there. Okay, I'm gonna fit it over the green screw. Again, nip it together and tighten up the screw. So now that the ground wire is all secured on the green ground screw, I'm ready to use my electrical tape. And you might be wondering, where am I going to put this electrical tape? Here's the thing that I've always been doing, and I think it's a really good safety measure. It's an added safety feature, I guess. It's something that I've learned over the years. I'm going to take my black electrical tape now, and I'm going to put a layer of this all the way around the reciprocal, and I'm going to cover up the heads of those screws, all four of them, and even the ground one, okay? So if you want, you can actually go around twice if you like. And let's do that. Let's get it really secured. It's an extra safety thing. And then to cut it, all you just gotta do is just pull it a little bit hard and hit weld break. So now I've got my electrical tape put around my reciprocal. You can probably see how it's all on there now. All my screws are tightened in, so you can't see them. I'm ready to shove my reciprocal into the box. So just be careful, just shove it in. Now, your reciprocal comes with two screws, and I've taken them off there a little while ago, and here they are. They're just 1-inch screws, and to put these on, I'm going to need my little Robinson screwdriver again, and I'm just going to put them in, and I'm going to secure the reciprocal now to the back of the box. Put the top one, okay? I'm gonna let that one go in so far so that it's good and tight, but not all the way until I get the bottom one in. When I get them both in, I'm gonna make sure that I have my reciprocal center in the box. I don't want into one side, okay, close to the side of the box, and I don't want into one side to the other. So I just wanna make sure that it's kinda fair in the box. So let me tighten it up a little bit more. Okay, here's the bottom one going in a little bit tight. Tightening up the top one. Okay, get her done. Just like Larry the Cable Guy says, get her done. Come on, Gary. Get her done, my buddy. Okay, almost there, folks. Okay, that bottom one is pretty good there now. Put the top one in. A little bit more. Okay, I'm just going to do a little visual here now just to make sure that my reciprocal is centering the box, that the space on either side of the reciprocal is the same. Some people put the reciprocals in the other way with the ground part of the reciprocal facing up. I've always put mine this way, and the way I look at it is that the part on the reciprocal that's for the ground is facing the ground, and it kind of looks kind of like a smiley face with the two on the top and then the ground one, right? So you can decide. You might want to put your reciprocal up the other way with the ground on top and the two plug parts down on the bottom, but this is how I like to install them. Okay, so it's all good and secure there now. Now I'm ready to put on my plate. And to put on the plate, I need my flat top screwdriver. Okay, so it just goes right on here. Okay, we're almost done here now, folks. Just get this one on.
Yeah.
I'll tell you. So, job finished. Reciprocal installed. Now, I wonder, do we have power? I'm going to go and check that out. I'm going to go get my jigsaw. I'm going to come back. I'm going to turn on the power to make sure that the wires are now live. And I'm just going to give this a test just to make sure that I do have some electricity in this reciprocal box. Okay, folks, I'm back with my trusty jigsaw. And as promised, we're going to do a test here now. We're going to see if, in fact, we did our wiring correctly and if the plug-in is actually going to work. While I was away, I also went and turned on the breaker in the panel box. So the wiring inside of this reciprocal box should be live. So let's do our test and see. Test number one. And it is a success. Test number two, let's try the bottom one. And that is a success also. I'm not surprised. I've been doing this kind of work for a long time now, folks, and I'm quite confident that my work is good, and I was pretty much sure that this was actually going to work. I didn't really need to go and get my trusty jigsaw to try it out, but you know, you gotta give it a try just to see, just to be sure it did work. So I wanna say thank you now. Thank you for being with me and following my step-by-step process on how to install a reciprocal outlet here in the old church. Thanks so very, very much. And again, of course, if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And that is Gary Betty Leet, the Old Church, 5 Acre Homestead.